Let's work the crackdown. We'll sequence all the way through a guard pass and a submission. So here we go. That's it. Snap, double chain, high crotch. Crack him down, and now we're going back out. Right, a good jiu-jitsu guy's going to want a hip escape. So as he does, I get to the center, and I put my leg, my shot leg, back into the center of his legs, okay? As you can see here, I'm going to run down his thigh till I get to the hip. Right, my first takedown, low shot, knee touch the mat. I'm going to do another takedown to pass him, right? Same analogy. Knee drove forward, hips went forward, took him down. Now, after I've taken him down, same technique chain, different position. Knee runs forward, hips go forward, I dominate this underhook, and I slide into side control. We call this a knee slide or a knee cutter. Now look, I'm gonna sequence to a submission right away. Post over his head, this knee is gonna draw a line down his lap to his hip. Throws a line down his lap to his inside hip. Boom. As I'm doing that, I'm pulling him to his side with this underhook arm. This leg steps over to the mid portion of his back. This thoracic spine area, not high, not low. I step over, and now my hips pivot behind the arm. This leg materializes over his head, and now I have an arm bar. Okay, so let's do one more. Nice medium speed, snap. Cracking down, he's up, I'm here. Now look, level change long. Run down his thigh, get to his hip. Clear that leg. Ideally, I want this elbow even in. If I can make my elbow and thigh touch, I'm in a really good spot. Right, because he's very difficult for me to guard recovery. Now look, swing the underhook, pull up on the arm, draw the line after my baseball slide. Knee runs from lat to hip. Pull him on his side, step over into the middle portion of his back. I'm gonna rotate, hug, this stays tight, slide, two hands on the wrist, pinch, hips up. Let's give it a shot, sequence, let's do it, 3, 2, 1.